Hey everyone, welcome to Grip Muscle Spotlight number 5. Today we are going to talk about the thumb, the strongest of our fingers. As you might know, the name thumb derives from the Germanic thuman or tuman, which means strong or swollen. It has the same roots like the word tumor, by the way. And the medical term for it is pollex, and pollex is just Latin from polio, which also means strong. So people knew all the time that the thumb is the strongest of our fingers because its name basically means strong. So let's talk about the strong one. Thumb can move into many different directions. Let's name them flexion, extension, adduction, abduction, and opposition. Now why can it do this? Because, if you imagine your thumb being like a flagpole, you see all these muscles are connected to the thumb like strings, and there are 9 of them. I've drawn them in different colors because we differentiate between intrinsic muscles. You have this small muscle ball in your hand under your thumb, which connects to your thumb, and extrinsic muscles, which come from the forearm. And if we count them, you will see that we have 1, 2, 3, 4 extrinsic muscles, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 intrinsic muscles. And all these 9 connect to the thumb and let it move into basically any direction it wants. This also makes sense now why the thumb is so strong, because 9 muscles is quite a lot for a finger. Let's talk about this muscle first. This is the first dorsal interosseous muscle. Dorsal is Latin for behind or back. So you can see this small landscape here on your skin. That is the first dorsal interosseus because it connects your index finger with your thumb. And if you imagine this small muscle as being kind of a string between the two, if you fixate your thumb, it will move your index finger to the side. But if you fixate your index finger, it does an adduction of the thumb. The next one, on the opposite side of the dorsal interosseus, is the adductor pollicis. You can see this, it is number 2. And its name names its function. It's an adductor. It makes this movement. It pulls the thumb toward the palm. It adducts. Talk about the last 3 intrinsic muscles of your hand. Those 3 are the ones that form the thenar, this small muscle belly up here. And remember them, they are called flexor, it's the first one, abductor is the second one, and opponens is the third one. So to remember them, just name them FAO or FAO. Okay, you can impress your friends now with your new knowledge about the hand. Let's talk about the flexor first. As its name suggests, it flexes your 2 joints of the thumb. Second one is the abductor. We have talked about the adductor, and the abductor does the opposite. It abducts the thumb away. Adduction, abduction. Okay, so these 2 movements, it pulls your thumb into this direction and abducts it. The last one is the opponens, and this one is really important because it enables the opposition of the other fingers. So if you want to grab something, you have to oppose your fingers. If you wouldn't have the opponens here, you couldn't do this. You could only like grab stuff like this, and that would suck, wouldn't it? You want to grab stuff like this. And those are the 3 thenar muscles, FAO, FAO. Another important thing is that we call the abductor and the flexor of the thenar the short flexor and the short abductor, so they are called brevis in Latin. And we also have the long ones. We have the long flexor here, and we also have the long abductor here. But I have talked about the long abductor and the extensors of the thumb in my other video, in Grip Muscle Spotlight number 2. So make sure to watch that, because I've covered these 3 already in great detail, the extensors of the thumb. The only one I haven't talked about yet is the flexor pollicis longus, the long one. It comes from up here. So if you extend your hand like this, so shortly below the brachioradialis, right here, there's your long flexor of your thumb. And as you can imagine, it goes up here. And I've drawn it like here, but it actually goes right up here into the joint. So here's where it connects. And now if you contract the muscle, it flexes the thumb really hard, really hard. Okay. So this was the basic anatomy already, 9 muscles. Now your knowledge about the thumb is probably better than before. And let's see what we can do with our thumb. I'm going to keep this really short here because the thumb basically has 2 functions that are used in sports. The first one is for opposition of the fingers, for example in a pinch grip. So if I want to pinch this, I have to oppose my other 4 fingers with the thumb. And the second example is this kind of grab. If I grab a towel or a rope in rope climbing, the thumb has to oppose the other fingers. This is a bad rope example, but you get the idea. If this was a rope, then my thumb would go around like this. Thanks for watching. This was Grip Muscle Spotlight number 5. I've kept it a little bit shorter this time to only implement the important information. And I hope that's okay with you. And if you learned something new about the thumb today, please make sure to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I would really appreciate that. See you next time. Goodbye.